Hey everyone, well this should be a bit of fun and something a little bit different. Now I feel a little bit weird doing this because it's not really in my nature to be overly critical of other guitar players. I can usually find something positive and good to say about pretty much anything I play, cover, and or listen to for that matter. However, this solo that we'll be talking about a little bit later on has been a curiosity to me for quite some time now. So we're going to have a look at it with maybe a bit of humor and my tongue firmly planted in my cheek. Having recently played my way through well over 100 of the greatest guitar solos of all time, my focus as of late has been pretty much directed at the all-time classic, really good to some of the most incredible guitar solos ever recorded. But today, we're going to look at one of the really bad ones, or is it? But first, a little chat about what some of us may consider to be a bad guitar solo, and what constitutes a so-called bad guitar solo. Now, objectively, there's a lot of really bad guitar solos out there. Subjectively, even more so. What you might think is a great guitar solo might make me and others want to tear our ears off. And what I think is a bad guitar solo might be one of your favorites of all time. And that's subjectivity for you. Some could be solos put down by a guitar player who just doesn't have the proper skills to pull off what's going on in his head. Keith Richards fits this description pretty well on any number of early Rolling Stones tracks, but especially the solo on their cover of Ain't Too Proud to Beg. Not your finest effort there, Keith. But Richards was and is a phenomenal rhythm guitar player, of course. He's just never been a very good soloist. Others can simply be a really bad solo put down by a very highly skilled player. The solo to Heat of the Moment by Steve Howe and Asia comes to mind here. What the hell was that, Steve? This one's doubly bad because you're supposed to be a guitar god. Or maybe it's just overindulgent wankery, misguided nonsense, poorly thought out, poorly played, poorly executed, boring, repetitive drivel. They all work, or in this case, considering the topic at hand, don't work. Lots of solos fall into these categories, too many to count, actually. Or maybe it's a perfectly executed guitar solo, note and technique-wise, but unfortunately sits in the entirely wrong song. The solo to Driven to Tears by Andy Summers and the Police comes to mind in that regard, though I do love the atonality of that one. But it really and truly comes out of absolutely nowhere and then disappears as fast as it arrived before sanity is restored in the track again. And speaking of atonality, maybe that's exactly what some guitarists were going for as well when it comes to, you know, when it comes to certain solos that many people may consider to be bad. Robert Fripp and Frank Zappa were masters of this. And there's subjectivity coming into play again. Or maybe the rough, sloppy, noisy, and loosely played solo, which some people might consider bad, is also exactly what the artist was going for. One that comes to mind here is Kim Thayil's solo to Soundgarden's Black Hole Sun, a solo which I love. In this case, however, it's exactly what he was aiming for. It was a condition that he put to the band for releasing such a lightweight, radio-friendly song. Thayil determined that the solo needed to be anything but lightweight. It needed to jar the listener out of complacency when it hit. Kurt Cobain and Neil Young are a couple of others that come to mind when it comes to the looser, chaotic, raw, and noisy type of guitar solo. Jimmy Page and the solo to Heartbreaker is another that often falls into this category. I mean, it's one of the greatest guitar solos ever recorded, and I love it personally. But lots of people think it's a sloppy mess. And it is a sloppy mess. But that's exactly what Jimmy was going for, and it's a glorious sloppy mess. So anyway, I just laid out a number of reasons why someone could consider a guitar solo to be bad. It's subjectivity for the most part. And like I said, sometimes there's a reason for its awfulness. And that is what I'm searching for in the solo that we'll be talking about today. Reason. Some people absolutely love this solo. They say that it reminds them of Neil Young. Yet for every comment on the YouTube video of this one that says that they love the solo, there's just as many, if not more, who say, what in the hell were they thinking? I'm edging towards the what in the hell were they thinking camp, but I'm not quite there yet. I honestly can't figure this one out. I don't know if I love it or absolutely hate it. Like I already said, it's a curiosity to me, this one. I'm legitimately fascinated by it. But maybe it's exactly what they were going for. Who knows? They know. And if this is indeed what they were going for, why? Is it poorly played? Yes. Does it fit the song that it's a part of? No. Is it jarring to the ear? Oh, yes. Does it go on far too long? Indeed it does. Is it an anomaly, a bad solo from a guitar player who normally plays much better? That I can't say, because the band's music isn't very heavy on guitar solos to begin with. Is it played loose and rough and raw for effect, like Neil Young or Kurt Cobain type solo? Yes, and I think this is the most likely culprit, but I haven't decided yet. However, to what effect? It is so far outside the tonal center of the song that it's a part of that this particular theory makes no possible sense to me. There is a lovely harmonica solo mid-song followed by a light and airy piano solo, and those are placed appropriately and fit the song perfectly. But then the outro solo is filled with raw emotional anger and aggression over a very, very calm shuffling beat. It just doesn't really fit. There's really no anger or angst in this song to call for it. It's a love song, and a beautiful love song at that, until. Now, I'm a fine dining waiter by trade, and last year I actually waited on this band when they were in town, and it was all I could do to try and control myself from asking them, what the bloody hell were you guys thinking with that guitar solo? I really legitimately wanted to know, but I restrained myself for a couple of hours and then finally let it go. This guitar player's girlfriend is actually from my small city of Halifax, Nova Scotia, and he comes in my restaurant fairly regularly, and I've gotten to know him a little bit. He's a super nice guy, quiet, I certainly do not mean any offense by this video. I'm just having a little bit of fun at your expense, Greg. Should you ever see this video, I have nothing but respect for you, your band, you as a singer, songwriter, and musician. Nothing but respect. But as a soloist, well, that's still up for debate. So without further ado, who is this guitar player, Greg, that I speak of? Who is this band? And most importantly for our discussion here today, which solo to which song? Well, the guitar player would be Greg Keeler, the band would be Blue Rodeo, and the song would be 5 Days in May. Blue Rodeo, if you don't know, is a very popular Canadian band that have been around for 25 years or so, released over 15 albums, and have had numerous big hits over the years, mostly in Canada. Their music is generally fairly light pop country folk rock, and they're very good at it. I like them a lot, one of my favorite Canadian bands. And this song, until the 5 minute mark at least, is very typical of Blue Rodeo's overall sound, a shuffling pop folk and country tinged love song, like I said. It's a really bloody great song with fantastic lyrics, awesome vocals from lead vocalist Jim Cuddy, and was a huge hit in Canada, stemming from their most successful 6-time platinum album, 5 Days in July. I'll post a link to the song down below in the description. It is a beautiful bit of songwriting, the 5-minute radio and video edit version, that is. The album version goes on for 2 whole minutes longer, and much of it filled with this curiosity of a guitar solo. Despite its rather raw and awful tone and total lack of vibrato on any of the notes, it at least starts out somewhat okay. He's at least in tune, if not way too loud in the mix. It starts with a bit of slow noodling that were the song to fade out at this point, it wouldn't sound terribly out of place. But no, he decides to keep going. And for some reason, nobody stopped him. After about 30 seconds, it starts to derail with a few very jarring and loud double stops, followed by a few poorly executed pinch harmonics. Then he starts really digging into the double stops, like the second coming of Jimmy Page, with most of them bent way out of pitch and dissonant notes clashing madly with each other. And remember now, this is a light, folky, country-tinged pop love song. But then comes the coup de grace, the pinch harmonic finale. They're not only poorly played and executed, they've lost all sense of melody and timing with regard to the underlying rhythms. This is about the most shocking and ear-abusing aspect of the whole solo. It's as if he learned how to do pinch harmonics that morning and decided that's what this song needed, whether he could pull them off or not. And for the most part, he couldn't. Or if he could, he didn't. But what baffles me the most isn't so much the playing, it's not very good, but the fact that someone, many someones in fact, including bandmates, producers, sound engineers, at the point when all was said and done, and when they're sitting around in the studio listening to the extended coda to this track, they decided, yep, that's the one. That's the one we're going with. It's a bad guitar solo. Objectively bad, I think. But is it so bad that it's good? I haven't decided yet. I called it awesome bad in the title of this video, but I don't know how much conviction I have in the awesome part of that title. But like I said, I am fascinated with it. So that tells me something right there. It certainly made a statement and left a mark, at least on me. But hey, you be the judge. Tell me what you think. Let's give this guy a listen, and then I'm going to try my best to replicate this beast. See how that goes. Should be fun. Problem is, I actually know very well how to do pinch harmonics. Might be tough screwing them up over and over and over again. But so anyway, enough build-up. Let's check this guy out. Well, now, what do you think of that? Now, like I said at the opening, I'm a bit uncomfortable criticizing other guitar players' works, but I thought this would be a fun video to make. It's just not something that I do very much, and I tend to steer clear of such things in my videos. But I'd love to know the story behind this creation, that's for sure. I read somewhere that the feel that the band was going for on the entire album was Harvest-era Neil Young. Maybe Greg Keeler was trying to channel Neil Young on this one. Who knows? He knows, I suppose. But that would be my guess. Neil certainly wasn't above putting a jarring mess of a solo dead center into one of his more easy-listening tunes. Southern Man comes to mind, Cortez the Killer, Like a Hurricane, you know. But those solos fit their themes. There's anger and fire in those lyrics, and the thematic tone of those tracks. Those solos fit, despite being loose, raw, and chaotic for the most part. This one just doesn't fit, and it's very jarring to listen to. It's certainly an oddity as far as Blue Rodeo's musical output goes. A band, like I said, that I am a big fan of. I listen to their greatest hits a lot in my car, and when this track comes on and the solo hits, I get very conflicted whether to turn it up or to turn it off. I'm sure that it's not just me, but I'm trying my best to convince myself of its brilliance, but I'm having a hard time of it. It's fun to play, though. I learned this one. And speaking of playing it, I'm going to give it my best shot and see how that shakes out. I'll close out this video with a cover of this beast, as best as I can manage, that is. So you guys take care of yourselves. I hope you enjoyed that. I hope you're well out there in your little guitar corner of the world. And we will see you next time. Cheers. Enjoy the solo for the second time. Or, you know, not.